Should you be working hard or should you be working smart? Well, smart seems the best way to go, right? But then again, what does it mean working smart? And that is what this video is gonna be about. I'm gonna show you how you can go from working hard to working smart. Not only for one time, for on each opportunity that you come across. So that every time you come across a situation thinking, should I be working hard or should I be working smart? That you can work from hard to smart and be efficient with your time as well. Because in the end, it's just a rinse and repeat procedure. If you apply this strategy for each and every stream of income that you have, you'll be set very soon. And of course, if you stay until the end, I'll even show you how you can get started right now, right today. Let's get into the video. Hey, what's up, you guys? Lucas here from xlwealth.com. Great that you joined in today, because in today's video, I'm gonna show you how working smart will make you rich. And of course, before we go into the video, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button, because that's the way how we can grow our community together. And of course, if you haven't checked out my latest book yet, be sure to click the link down below in the description to get your own copy right now. It's my book on how I started investing just in my team with only $25 in my pocket, and actually how I started my building whole, my whole real estate portfolio. Be sure to click the link down below and get your own copy. And currently, even the ebook of mine is on special offer. Okay, let's get into the video for now. Now, the first step in this procedure is very simple. You gotta make money. Now, you might be thinking, Lucas, are we gonna go into this route again? Well, you gotta see it like this. You gotta start somewhere. In the end, we're talking about how working smart will make you rich. If you don't work at all, you can't make any money, right? You gotta see that as well. So you gotta start making money first. Now, in the beginning, most likely, you can actually work with your hands and make some money that way. For example, being in a supermarket, or I don't know, walking people's dogs. You think about it, it's up to you. You gotta make money first. The first things are, you gotta be able to pay for your necessities. Yes, you gotta put in time and effort to get that money rolling. The thing is, what do you do with the excessive money? It is so important for you to have a goal and a plan for the money that you have extra. Most likely, you're gonna spend more as well. And this is so important. This is why you gotta have a plan. If you don't have a plan for your money, most likely is you're gonna spend too much on things you absolutely don't need yet. In the end, you gotta see it like this. You only got 24 hours in a day, just like every other person. There's a reason why a wealthy person thinks in wealthy ways. Like, I gotta spend my time very efficiently. You could spend like your time making $4 an hour, or you can use that same hour to make $20 an hour. Makes a lot of sense, right? But the question is always, how do I do that? And yes, that's a very good question. There are so many ways how we can get to Rome. Find ways to make money and find ways to make lots of it. Now, step number two in this whole procedure is, of course, what should you do with the money? Well, it's as easy as that. The first thing is, start saving the money. Start setting money aside and let the money apply in the goal that you've set for your money. Now, it seems very simple, like you gotta set a goal for your money. Well, yes, in the end you do. But if you don't set a certain goal for your money, most likely you're gonna save your money, let it just, you know, sit and simmer on the bank, saying like, whoa, we're doing nothing here. I'll tell you this, money's gotta get to work as well. Just like you. You're working for money, while money's gotta be working for money as well. And in the end, I would say, what to do with your money? Invest it. Because if it just sits around on your bank account doing nothing on your savings account, yeah, it's just getting uncomfortable saying like, I don't know what to do here. And most likely, if you have that, I don't know, like $6,000 on your bank account, watching those videos on YouTube saying like, ooh, this is the new graphics card that I could buy using the money I have on my account. Well, most likely what's gonna happen is you're gonna spend the money, because you're gonna tell yourself why it's necessary to get things that might be unnecessary the moment you don't have the money. But the moment you do have the money, you have the feeling like, the money is talking to me, I need to spend it. And that is how it goes every time again. This is why, have a goal for your money as well. Have a goal for you. Have a goal for all the things you do. And then the money will get to work. The hardest part is the self-discipline that you need to apply the moment you set your money aside. Because yes, money doesn't work by itself. You gotta put it to work. Now, step number three in this procedure is very simple. The question always pops up again. We've got step number one, we know that we gotta make a ton of money. Step number two is, yeah, we gotta either save it or invest it. Step number three in this says, what to invest in, right? We've made the choice, we're gonna set money aside every month again. Now, where do I invest it in? Now, the best advice is, of course, invest your money in assets that bring money back to you. It seems very simple, okay? We could say like, you know what? I'm gonna invest in an old car, in an antique car that I bought for, I don't know, like $30,000. I'm gonna put the car in a very nice place and I'm gonna take very good care of the car, and in 30 years' time, the car will be worth millions. And yes, situations like these have happened before. But the thing is, we don't really value these things like antique cars all the time. This is why if you have a little bit amount of money, you can't buy an antique car. You can't do that. But what you can buy is you can buy a certain stock of a certain company and let that grow over time. And yes, you gotta do your research. And if you can scale up, for example, buy real estate, because real estate has so many benefits, like it grows in equity over time, the rental income grows over time, and of course, your mortgage goes down over time. So in the end, it's only growing on three ends. That's a great thing to do. This is why people love investing in real estate. But no matter what choice you make and what to invest in, it needs to be something that grows over time. And especially the great thing is if you can actually control the growth as well. Now, for example, the real estate, it grows in value over time because you already know the moment somebody lives in your home and they pay you rental income every month, it's growing on both ends. So yeah, that's something that you have in control. When we take a look at the antique car, well, yes, I might have spent 30K buying that car, but if I don't take good care of it, because you know I leave it in a garage that is not insulated or something, for example, and we get more rust, dude, the value of the car is gonna drop over time, not gonna rise. Yes, the rusty car is also very fancy and very nice. But then again, if there's too much rust, most likely the value of the car is gonna drop. And so yes, choose an investment that makes money over time, or at least grow in value over time. Now, as you can see, this procedure is very simple. You gotta rinse and repeat this. Every time, you gotta think, okay, I gotta make more money. And if you can, scale the income, because you gotta start working from working hard to working smart. You gotta make a choice. What do I do with my time? If you keep on working and doing the same thing, it's not gonna change anything. But you gotta make a choice. What is important that I still have to do in this, and what choices can be shifted to somebody else? You gotta make a choice in this. So for example, you're doing a paper round. If you can get somebody else doing that paper round for you for a little bit less money than what you get per hour, you've outsourced the work to somebody else already. Now, I'm not saying that you should do this, but I'm just saying this is an example. Outsourcing work to other people so that they can do the work for you, and yet you can get a little bit of money and take no risk of losing money. This is why it's so important. Risk management and control management. You gotta put them together, and hey, there you have it. You can start working smart. It is so important. The moment you know what choices can be made from shifting working hard to working smart, every time you can move it forward, you can move it forward, you can move it forward, and then you have more money left at the end by not doing more work, but by controlling the work. And there you have it. There you have your time, you've played up, you've freed up time again so that you can invest that time in something new. And each time the money is left there, you can let that work again. And yes, in the end, it's just a rinse and repeat procedure that keeps on going. And this is how the wealthy grow their wealth over time as well. Not only using the properties that grow in over time, but especially each and every opportunity they take on, they work very hard in it, and then move on from working hard to working smart. And yes, they don't need a lot from each opportunity, they just need enough benefits from each opportunity. And this way, they can grow their wealth over time. And every time they are left with a profit, they invest the profit. And this is how you can grow as well. And since you stayed until the end of this video, I wanna share a bonus step with you. Now, before all this, before step 1-4, the very important step that you should always take first, I would call this step 0. Now, why is this step 0? You gotta educate yourself first. You gotta have a clear direction that you're gonna go into. If you don't have a clear direction, what happens most likely is that you're gonna have full speed ahead in possibly the wrong direction. And that's not what you want to. This is why it's so important to educate yourself first. I always say, if you're not educated, most likely Yeah, you just gotta do something because you feel that is a good choice. But in the end, you gotta know why you go in a certain direction because you learned this is a good direction. Otherwise, it's just, you know, based on your emotions. Think like, ooh, this is a great idea to do so. But yeah, if you don't know what you're doing, most likely you're gonna put all your time and effort in the wrong things. That will be a waste of your time. And yes, time is money. So therefore, educate yourself. Now, financially educate would even be better in this case. And what to do than this? Well, like I said, there are so many people that you can learn from. There are so many people you think, hey, this is a great person to learn from. Make the choice saying like, you know what? I'm gonna learn from this person. My question is, why not reach out to the person? Now you could be saying, ooh, I wanna be learning from Tony Robbins. Great, do that. Now, is Tony Robbins being very personal? I don't know. Yeah, I find it really hard to reach Tony Robbins on the phone saying, hello, Tony.
Hello, Lucas.
Can I get some personal coaching from you?
Yes, and that will cost you $100,000.
Yeah, so that's not gonna be it, right? They can be very successful, but in the end, you wanna be learning from people who are close to you, who are, you know, in your range, and yet who you can learn from and they can teach you personally. That is what you want. You wanna have people who can teach you the basics either way so that you can get started. And there are so many people out there, people who actually offer their services saying like, you know what, I can help you out and actually make a deal on the price that they're offering to you. And this is actually it. Be sure to educate yourself before getting started at all. I thank you very much for watching today's video. If you liked the video, of course, be sure to hit the like button because that's the way how we can grow our community. And of course, if you want to be subscribed to the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And of course, if you want to be notified every time a new video comes out, be sure to click that notification bell as well. But most importantly, of course, if you want to get a copy of my book, be sure to click the link down below in the description to get your own copy now so that you can actually start reading like, okay, so what did Lucas do in his past? Well, it's something you can do as well today. Okay, thank you very much. Happy investing, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.